In an open field in La Urtown, Nueva Ecija, personnel of the Philippine Army and U.S. Army Pacific fired shot after shot. Using the American troops' High Mobility Artillery Rocket System, or HIMARS, they fired at a target which was 11 kilometers away from the launch area. But all of this is only a simulation, part of the two armies' live fire exercises under the Salaknib 2023.
HIMARS are a uniquely usable weapon system in terms of the artillery, in a sense that as a rocket artillery unit, it's wheeled instead of tracked. It gives you a little more mobility, it's a little lighter, it gives you air mobility on certain fixed-wing platforms. But yeah, it's a little bit more agile. Demonstrated an occupation and what it looks like to fire a HIMARS weapon system.
The HIMARS has a range of around 80 kilometers. Filipino troops were taught how to operate this advanced weapon system in various scenarios.
It is important for us to get familiarized on the operation of HIMARS because we all know that we are now transitioning from internal security operations to territorial defense operations. There is ongoing conferences, deliberations on what specific equipment to procure. And I think HIMARS is one of the possible solutions to our capability gaps.
The soldiers also fired 84 84-millimeter anti-tank weapons, which are usually used for nearer targets.
It's a shoulder-launched, unguided, single-use anti-armor weapon system. This is designed to be used and operated by the soldier in the field on the front lines of the battlefield and used to destroy targets within a line of sight of the intended target. Check the black blast area.
This is the first time the Philippine Army and U.S. Army Pacific utilized the anti-tank weapon in the Salaknib. For Philippine and U.S. officials, interoperability among the soldiers is crucial, and this is further enhanced by holding joint drills.
The ability to exchange American soldiers for Filipino soldiers inside of tactics has been super seamless for us. They're very proficient at everything they do, and there is really no difference in between us and them. We've been conducting missions out in the jungle because I just got done with the jungle school with the Filipino soldiers, and it was very easy to go and execute the same drill.
The first phase of the Salaknib exercise will conclude next week. The second phase will be conducted in the second quarter of the year. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News, Nueva Ecija.